What's up, movie lovers? I'm Mike, and this is Gotta Love Them Movies. So, you probably have noticed I'm not at home, I'm not in New York, I'm out traveling. Doesn't matter where I am. What matters is Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. It was okay. I felt that it could have delivered on the promise of Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. You know, here's the thing. I was trying to think during the film and then even after the movie, I was like, what is the story of this movie? The best that I can surmise is that Newt Scamander comes to America for an extremely vague reason. He explains why he's in America, but they don't ever do anything with it, you know? Then there is the subplot, which turns out to be like the main plot, but then other stuff happens. Here's what we love about the Harry Potter series, okay? There's an entry point into the story. Harry Potter, the boy who lived, is our entry point into the whole wizarding world, and we learn about it through Harry's eyes. So Harry is just bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. He wants to know what this whole wizarding thing is about, right? And that's cool. That's awesome. Because we, the viewer, we can be part of that. We can be part of his journey. So with Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, it already assumes that we know all about this world, which we kind of do, but not the American side of the wizarding world. So let me break this film down. Acting. I don't know. It was okay. I didn't have any major problems with anyone's acting. But it also wasn't like there was nothing about it that blew me away. Dan Fogler is not one of my... I'm so surprised he was in this movie. There's nothing about Dan Fogler that jumps out at me and says, hey, we can put this guy into the wizarding world. Nope. You know what? Eddie Redmayne's performance wasn't even that charismatic. He's not even that likable as a character. I love you, Eddie Redmayne, but Newt Scamander may not be your strongest role. Acting, you're getting a 13. So directing. Director David Yates. Is this his third outing in a Harry Potter film or fourth? This movie suffers from tone deficiency. Is this going to be dark and serious, like Harry Potter 8? Or is it going to be fun and lighthearted, like Harry Potter 1? Or is it just going to be dark and scary, like The Conjuring? There is a moment in this film that is genuinely terrifying. It was sensory overload. I didn't expect what was coming, and what came I found to be genuinely terrifying. Now, I'm 34 years old, and I would venture a guess that there's probably some children who are going to go see this movie who are going to be genuinely scared. So I find that a little disconcerting. David Yates, you're getting the highest mark of today's score, which is 15. Writing. J.K. Rowling, you wrote the script for this. You're taking full writing credit and story credit. The story could have been more linear. We didn't have an entry point into the story of Newt Scamander. Like, I still don't know who Newt Scamander is. I left the theater not knowing who this guy was, what his background is. I just know he's some guy who's writing a book who's going around collecting animals. There's a moment where a particular store gets trashed. And that could have, like, had they storyboarded that whole sequence better, that could have been so much fun. And it wasn't. It was just a thing that happened. It was like you were waiting for something else to happen, and while you were waiting for that other thing to happen, this thing happens, and you're like, okay, well, I guess I'm going to be entertained by this thing happening over here. I really am waiting for this to happen over here, but, you know, we'll just kind of kill some time and look at this thing over here. But this thing over here could have been really cool. It could have been a lot of fun, and they didn't put it to good use. And I feel like that is the case with many parts of this movie. I'm not really sure who the bad guy was. I don't know what the motives of the bad guy are. That was never talked about. That was never explained. And this is why the Harry Potter films were so successful. We had clear, defined relationships between the characters. We knew everyone's motivation. Everything was defined, and nothing was defined in this film. And then there was a subplot that kind of became more... Yeah, that's the thing. The subplot became more important than anything else. And, like, in the Harry Potter movies, every story is a mystery. Who is the Prisoner of Azkaban? Who is the Half-Blood Prince? What is the Chamber of Secrets? What is the Sorcerer's Stone? Like, all of these things are... Like, each book is a mystery in and of itself. Stuff like that is not well transposed into this film. And for that reason, JK... you get a 10. So effectiveness. How effective was this movie? Like I said before, the title, Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. We saw a few creatures. I wouldn't really call anything a fantastic beast. Have no idea where to find them. The whole reason that we're watching this film is... to be brought back into the wizarding world. And we kind of are. So I think from a fan perspective, that's what I wanted to see. I wanted to see more of like, what does it really mean to be a wizard or a witch in like 1920s America? That would have been really cool to see. And we never really did get to see that. So overall effectiveness, you're getting a 10. Which brings us to takeaway. What is the overall takeaway of this film? That's a tough one. Because I think it kind of failed on a lot of levels. The whole point of these movies is to have fun and to actually showcase various scenarios in life through the wizarding world on how we can be better people, on how we can... There's so many characters that you can latch on to. Are you a Harry Potter? Are you a Ron Weasley? Are you a Hermione Granger? Are you an Albus Dumbledore? Dumbledore. Are you Dumbledore? I didn't ever feel like I was in the wizarding world. It fell very short of its mark, in this guy's opinion. Overall takeaway from this is maybe take care of your own mistakes. That's what I'm going with. If you make a mistake, fix it. So overall takeaway, you're getting an 8. So that brings us to an overall score of 56 out of 100.
If you do not speak English, I am at your disposal with 187 other languages along with their various dialects and sub-tongues.
Colloquial English will do fine, thank you.
So guys, did you see Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them? Let me know. I want to know in the comment section below. Guys, you can follow me on Twitter at GLTMovies. If you like this video, click like. If you really like this video, click subscribe. And if you really, really like this video, click share. Because that's what Newt Scamander would want you to do. Also, JK Rowling. If you ever happen to be in Slough, in the greater Slough area, which is in the greater London area, go to the Empire Cinemas and look at my good friend Elliot Brimble. You can have some major awesome conversations with that dude. All right, movie lovers, I'm out of here.